Hello everyone, it is time to listen to another song today. This one is called Violent Thing by Ben Dolich, or Dolich, not sure, from Germany. And I can already see that this is a rather long video, because I'm guessing there will be a bunch of filler, silence, or video special things. So I'm not gonna ramble on this one, so we'll get through it in time. So let's just get right into it. Ooh, the dance beats. I hear them. What a storyline we're setting up here. Okay, great contrast in the first chorus there. Interesting voice. Knocking me down like a domino. You know that I'm right here. I'm working on nice. I'm waiting on something. That's an unexpected rhythm in the piano. I'm liking it, how they play on the offbeat. And here comes the drums. The drum machine into it. The bass line is super funky. It's very danceable, very enjoyable in that sense. They're playing around a little bit with it as well. His voice is really interesting. So unexpected. Okay, the electric guitar. Alright, it's a very 70s effect on this guitar going in here. Very filtered out as well. The drums are quite constant, so there's still energy in it, you know? That's nice. I'm liking these offbeat piano chords. I really am. And the bass line is really cool. Okay, yeah, we didn't need this. Solid drum fill. Kind of lost me when you broke up the song. It keeps itself refreshing, I think. Okay, we've got some horns. Nice! You know, just an additional harmony to keep up something refreshing in it. I like that, when they take that into consideration. Okay, breakdown still has the bass line in it, so we still have the energy, you know, the pulsating feeling there. Good way to put it together. We've got these big sweeps. And the electric guitar in focus. I like how they made this breakdown. They made sure that there's still energy in it, you know? It's really nice. Even though they filtered out the drums so much. Drum fills. It's really solid. Really solid. Good production as well. Everything sounds polished. The horns are a great addition to this. I like how they've been added here towards the end. It's quite abrupt there at the end, but that was enjoyable. It really was. I'm not entirely sure what I think of it as an entirety just yet, but there was so many cool things about it, and I think they've done a really professional job. They've really taken into consideration how to, you know, arrange the song as an entirety to constantly keep it refreshing, because many songs fail to do that. This one doesn't. I believe that they've taken into consideration when and where they should add certain elements and certain variations to the song to just keep it going. So that's a great part of it. His vocal style is, you know, super unique and super interesting. So I was a bit skeptical on it first, but it was really enjoyable to have something, in that higher register contrast. Mainly, I mean the groovy bass line and the incredibly, deep lying, what do you call it, with the dynamics. They've equalized the drums quite far down in the register, so it's a nice contrast between the two. I like the electric guitar inputs. It's simple but effective with these palm muted kind of strumming patterns. I'm liking the horns. I mean, I usually do, but they were added in such an effective way here because they were so sparse with do you say that? Sparse? I don't even know, but you get it. They weren't used too frequently, and they were used at places maybe you didn't expect them to. Like when they first introduced them, it could have been easily made so that they were just gonna overuse them from that point on. But no, they didn't. They just hinted them, and then they brought them back in the final chorus towards the end when everything came together. Really nicely done. I like that. You hint towards something that's coming later, earlier in the song, but you don't overdo it. It's really nice. I just think arrangement-wise, this song is really has no flaws to that side of things. Production was solid, really well put together. Maybe, I'm not sure. There was something about it that didn't strike me completely, but I really can't name it. I think I just need to listen to it again. It is rather like other pop songs these days, with the nostalgic vibes back to the disco era or whatever you call it. You do have that tendency in a lot of modern pop music, and it's obvious that they've taken the inspiration from there to really latch on to this hype train that we're on. But I mean, it's fine. I don't mind it. I just hear a lot of it, so maybe that's what's keeping me from absolutely loving this one. But I mean, songwriting wise, arrangement wise, I have no issues with it. It's a great pop song. I really think so. So now it's time for you to tell me what you think of it, and you do so by writing in the comments, and we can discuss it. So other than that, I will see you in the next one, and take care until then. Bye.